Good afternoon, everyone. It's an honor to be here amongst you all lovely people. Some familiar faces in the crowd. I see a lot of people sitting on the front seat who I know. So thank you for joining. So I'm Dinesh Kasari and I represent Shri Krishna Paper Mills company, which is manufacturing high-strength graph papers. And I'm supposed to be talking on the topic changing market dynamics on graph paper. I hope I do justice on the topic. So before I begin, can I know who all are married here in the room, all men? So I speak this on behalf of all the married men. घर पे तो वीडियो के सामने बोलने का मौका मिलता नहीं, तो यही प्लेटफॉर्म्स हमें मिलते हैं जहाँ पे हम कुछ बोल पाते हैं. And I'm really thankful to Shraddha because today I'll be speaking and she'll be listening. So I thank you, mom, dad. I'm here because of my dad. So thank you, mom, and Salil and Nikhil, my really close friends, and all of you wonderful people sitting at the back. So let's get right into it. The topics I'll be covering today are basically the global graph paper market, a perspective, the Indian graph paper market, changes, curious case of shipping lines, and of course the conclusion of future trends. So question to the audience, how much do you think in million tons, how much paper in million tons are we consuming every year? Just a random guess. How much paper are we consuming in million tons every year? 500? Very close. Very, very close. It's actually about 450 million tons of paper we're consuming every year. So this is the total paper consumption year on year, which includes everything. Now, how much of this is attributed to packaging? How much of this is attributed to packaging? 30? 80? So actually this is the right answer. It's 55% attributed to packaging and the other papers attribute 45%. So you see this graph here. This pointer is supposed to work but it's just not working, so never mind. So if you see the blue line, the blue trend line is moving up continuously and the black trend line is going down. So this shows you that packaging is basically growing and other graphic papers and newsprint is all going down. So this is what I mentioned earlier, 55% wrapping and packaging, 26% writing printing, and newsprint and other specialty papers, about 20%. Now, globally, a perspective of how much value-wise, what are we doing in container board and craft globally? So we are talking about $140 billion of craft container board every year, which is supposed to go forward to $160 billion in the next 5 years. China and US account for almost 50% production between them. China has consistently increased production since 2000. So one interesting fact here which I would like to mention is that in the year 1980s, US dominated the paper production market, manufacturing 60% of the paper, right? Since then, China has come into the market and grown year on year. They've added capacities. So today, China is 30% and US is flat. So between them, they are 50% today in world production. And no surprises there. China jo karta hai, bada hi karta hai. So it consumes 1/4, 25% of the entire paper coming from the world alone. So 100 million tons out of 400 million tons or so to China, followed by Europe, US, Japan, out of which 55% is craft and board. So this is total paper, out of which 55% is craft and board. Now, we all know what is per capita consumption, right? Per capita consumption is simply paper used per person by an individual in the country. Now, why I'm showing this chart to you is very, very interesting and something that you want to ponder upon. India's biggest populous country in the world is China, right? We all know that. So China is the most populous nation in the world. China's per capita consumption is 75, less than half of that of US. US is 200 plus, right? But China is the most populous country in the world. Second to China is India. But if you were to take a guess of what is India's per capita consumption, any random guess? Is that 10, 20? 9? 9-0? 1-9?
Only 9,
okay. So he's quite close, but the answer is 15. So if you see, China's per capita consumption is 75, and India is only 15. So what this really shows is that when India will grow in terms of consumption, so will the consumption of per capita grow with people. So say, because we are the most second most populous country, we see a lot of growth coming here now. This is a timeline. I need help from with the laptop to just press the timeline. So this is a moving graph. Just keep your eyes on the screen. So you see where we are starting with. We are starting with China sitting at about 80 million tons and US at 70 million tons. Now see how the graph is moving. You see India coming up there on the map. You see China considerably increasing their production over the years. Yeah. So what you end with is 25% reduction in the last 10 years. China has increased 25% production. US has remained flat. US has stayed at 70. Good news for India, India's come in the top 7. Right? So this is what I wanted to show you on this moving chart. So we all know the famous country China. China is somehow involved in everything they do today. So, you know, China bolta kuch hai, karta kuch hai, lekin hota bahut kuch hai. So when it comes to China, we need to understand what's really happening out there. And we know that solid waste rules have changed in the last 4 years or so, which has really caused a lot of changes in the paper market. And I'll take you through some points here. So yeah, solid waste rules changed 2018 onwards, for a complete ban of solid waste 2021. So from being an exporter, they became an importer, which I will show you in the next chart. And this led to reverse container movement and demand and supply of finished goods. So this is a chart you really want to put your eyes on. On the left hand side are exports and on the right hand side are imports. So now before the ban, China is a net exporter. So you see the trend line starting in 2013, right? So they're going from 190 US million to 350 million. So they're increasing their exports year on year. Suddenly after the ban, they go to 100 million. So one third right after the ban, right? And on the right side is exports, is imports. So they're sitting at on an average 700 million US dollars, jumps up to 1.3 billion US dollars right after the ban. So this shows that basically China has become a net importer of kraft, uncoated kraft. A lot of capacities have been increased, India, Vietnam, a lot of other countries in Southeast Asia. Yeah. So right now, this is what we need to look out for. In terms of Indian kraft in the market, of course, Indian craft, Indian paper mills changed their direction. They moved from newsprint writing printing grades to packaging. Total craft production today in India is at about 18 million tons per annum. At its peak, India exported about 30% of its craft to China, which was up by 40% in the last 3 years because of the China ban. Although volatility and quality parameters are still a challenge for the paper mills, especially on the Gujarat side. Obviously, we all know in the last 6 to 8 months what a nightmare the paper mills have gone through. There was basically no fiber available, and quality fiber always remains a challenge in India. Now, need for sustainability. We've heard this term many times that we need to be sustainable, we need to use recycled paper, and we need to shift from plastic to paper. We need to understand that being sustainable now is not an option. It's something, it has to be a lifestyle. So recycling has to be a way of life. Only then can we be sustainable. Today, if you see, the reason we have to talk about sustainability is we've all seen images of marine life, cattle life getting affected due to plastic. Now the question is, when you talk about sustainability, you need to always talk about recycling ratio. The recycling ratio of a country is something very simple. How much paper are we able to recover in that economy and put back in the ecosystem? Unfortunately, India is nowhere near the map. So if you see the map, it starts with World Air Average and goes to China, right? India is not there. Because India's recycling ratio is about 30%, which is half of the world average, which is where the cause of concern is. The developed nations like Australia, Japan, US, Europe, all in the high 70s. So as a country, globally, we need to become a self-reliant increase recycling ratio country where we can supply at least recover fiber which is available in the country. The other discussion, of course, which is important is the difference between virgin and recycled pulp. Why are we trying to move towards recycled pulp? Obviously, it's a case of sustainability. It's recycled is more in right now. Everybody wants recycled. But the volume efficiency, look at the volume efficiency. 1 ton of recycled paper, you need 1.4 tons of recovered fiber. Whereas in terms of pulp, look at the numbers. You need almost 4 trees to make 1 ton of virgin pulp, right? So, as against vis-a-vis the quality of paper. Now, quality of paper, yes, I agree. Virgin quality, you can't get that to recycle. But these are some things we need to ponder about. We're going to see a lot of more blues coming in the next few years of countries abandoning plastic. So, a lot more blues coming in the next few years. The last few slides in my presentation, and this is one topic which is probably more famous than COVID. Because COVID pain was temporary. Shipping pain is permanent. Because shipping lines have basically done what they wish at their fancies, and we have a solution with them. So, you know, there's a term called shipping freight index. Can anyone guess how much it's gone up in the last 3 years? 500%. Is there any businessman in this room who's made 500% revenues in the last 3 years? Or has grown 500%, I really doubt. Shipping freight index from $1,800 to $11,000. 500% and not stopping, right? Now we know that shipping lines are very bad, very logistics are very bad, whatever they do. But we need to understand what really happened out there. Why this really happened out there. Reason number one, when COVID came in 2020, everything stopped, right? There was no global trade. Containers got stuck from where they were. Shipping lines lease a lot of containers. So they had to give the extra containers back to the leasing companies because who's going to pay for it? Then work stopped getting affected because of COVID. Drivers getting affected due to COVID. There were not enough people to get your containers out from your factories to the ports, from the ports to the point of destination. Basically leading to limited container availability. Now what happened is, suddenly there was a sharp recovery in quarter 3, 2020. Businesses boom. Shipping lines realized we don't have the people. So what do we do? Containers can't bring back. So the price went up. Price went up and started. Now what was happening is China's economy did better than other economies. China mein to COVID aaya hi nahi. Hum log mere hisab se. Don't quote me on this. So US and Europe started exporting much lesser than what they used to. So what the shipping companies did is, they realized that the empty cargo is unfavorable to bring back to Asia. So they kept increasing the rates. Now it's very simple. I asked you today, if my paper is going to sell at 5 times the price and you're willing to pay for it, why would I lower the price? I'm going to increase the price. And this is what's happened. Shipping lines have kept raising the prices because you all sitting here paid for it. We all have kept paying the prices. So there was no motivation for them to reduce the prices. Rates have surged 4 to 5 times on a price which is earlier 1/5. Although we have to give it to them that there was unpredictability in the trade. There were new strains coming up. Then now the war has come. Then, you know, obviously China's latest COVID situation, which again, I would not quote them. And we also have to understand one more important fact that the world is dependent on China, right? On this map, if you see the 4 reasons, and I'll just walk you through the reasons. First wave, sanitizer kahan se aayega? China se. PP kit kahan se aayega? China se. Glove kahan se aayenge? China se. Mask kahan se aayega? China se. Right? Second wave, dawaiyon ki intermediaries kahan se aayengi? China se. Pharmaceutical companies will basically standard ki hame dawaiyon ki intermediaries kahan se milengi? Now when the businesses boom, we all started looking for inputs. अरे केमिकल कहाँ से आएगा? चाइना से. मशीनरीज कहाँ से आएंगी? चाइना से. फिर मोदी जी कहते हैं जी घर बैठिए, बाहर मत जाइए, घर से ही काम करिए. भाई साहब लैपटॉप कहाँ से आएंगे? चाइना से. तो वी आर सो डिपेंडेंट ऑन चाइना दैट वी रियली कांट डू एनीथिंग विदाउट देम. एंड दे शिपिंग लाइन्स रियलाइज दिस दैट देयर इज गोना बी वन वे ट्रैफिक, सो प्राइसेस बढ़ाओ. कमिंग टू द सॉल्यूशन, देयर इज अ डिस्क्लेमर हियर. इस रूम में कोई नहीं अगर सोल्यूशन दे सकता है, मैं तो बिल्कुल भी नहीं हूँ, बट वेन इट कम्स टू बेसिक बिजनेस दीज आर सम ऑफ द फैक्टर्स विच कैन रिड्यूस द प्राइस ऑफ शिपिंग लाइन्स. वी नीड टू गेट सम नॉर्मलसी बैक इन ट्रेड. सीरियसली कोविड के बाद देयर हैज बीन नथिंग नॉर्मल, नथिंग हैज बीन वर्किंग नॉर्मल. Prices of fiber have shot up, there has been a shortage of paper, shipping lines have got containers stuck here and there, empty containers need to be brought back to the ports, and now the war has started. So literally speaking, we need to get some normalcy back in the trade, right? Now talking about future trends, this is the last slide of the presentation. We start with the tip of the iceberg, as always China. अब चाइना में कोविड चल रहा है, ऐसा वो कहते हैं कि चाइना में कोविड चल रहा है. नाउ इट्स गोना डिपेंड कि वहां क्या होगा. इफ द सिचुएशन ऑफ चाइनाज कोविड गेट्स थ्रू इन द नेक्स्ट 15-20 डेज, एक्सपेक्ट अ लॉट ऑफ चेंजेस इन द पेपर मार्केट. फाइबर प्राइसेस शूटिंग अप अगेन, लॉट ऑफ डिस्ट्रप्शंस हैपनिंग इन शिपिंग लाइंस बिकॉज नथिंग इज हैपनिंग इन चाइना राइट नाउ. सडनली व्हेन समथिंग हैपेंस इन चाइना वी ऑल नो व्हाट हैपेंस, द वर्ल्ड चेंजेस राइट. सो कीप वॉचिंग दैट स्पेस. इन 15 डेज इफ चाइना ओपन्स अप, एक्सपेक्ट अ लॉट ऑफ चेंजेस. Future trends in markets will depend on what policies China has. In terms of production in the US and Europe, many mills have moved towards recycled fiber. Many new productions have come up from other grades to packaging grades. So there's an increased reliance of fiber requirement in those countries. Thailand, Vietnam have also joined the export part of China. In India especially, power and fuel play a major challenge because of the war. Now coming to plastic ban. Plastic ban is not just forced anymore, right? So it's getting very real. So if you aren't geared up in your business for the plastic ban, you're slow. Companies move towards the recycling logo. It's more like a CSR activity now. Expect more states and countries to implement the ban. In India, a lot of innovations in machines are happening. We heard Raghav speak about innovations in packaging and product. So in India, a lot of innovations happening in packaging segments, in capacities, in machineries. But when you need good products and good innovations, you need good fiber. So because of Europe opening up, fiber has eased, it's available, it's volatile, fiber price has gone down, but again, it's a short-term phenomenon as per me. India is always going to be a fiber deficient country. So we need to really get on the recycling ratio part. We need to increase the recycling ratio in India so that jo hai wo to hum utilize kare. And in terms of innovations, we definitely see a lot of things happening. So to close the presentation, guys, I really believe when I say this that we all need to kind of collaborate here. All people sitting here need to collaborate. Mill owners, packaging experts, chemical suppliers, and consumers. We need to come together because India is the market to watch out for in the next 5 years. Jo hona India mein hona, I can guarantee you that. And if you compete, you will not get anything. But if you collaborate, you will get everything. So if you collaborate together, I'm telling you this, and believe me, guys, if we come together to bring innovative solutions in craft paper, we can really make India a global marketplace and a global player in the market. So some of the sources used as below. If you need any information on the sources, I'll be happy to share them in the end of the presentation. And thank you once again, guys. This is Dinesh Pasari from Shingesha Paper Mills, the manufacturer of craft papers. Thank you for being a lovely audience. Thank you.